Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarans on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. It is November 5th, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday. First article of interest. Deputy, enough time to pass the government budget 2020-19, 40-November 4th, 2019. MP Sarin Abbas Alili, on Monday, that if the blocs agreed to question the Prime Minister, the matter according to the law needs 3 months with the lowest estimates, indicating that it is enough for the current Council of Ministers to complete the draft budget 2020. Interrogation of the Prime Minister according to the Constitution goes through many stages and needs a long time, Alioi said. He added that if the blocs agreed to question him, it takes a law and reality for nearly 3 months, noting that the duration during the period of interrogation or without him enough for the Council of Ministers to complete the draft budget 2020 and send to Parliament and approved. He explained that the passage of the 2020 budget and a number of laws are an urgent necessity at the current stage for fear of falling into a constitutional vacuum. Next article of interest. Al-Tamimi, Iraq is on the verge of returning to Article 7, 08 to 47 November 5, 2019 Baghdad. The legal expert Ali Al-Tamimi, Tuesday, that RAC FTE are leaving the 7th to the 6th, it is heading again to that item as a result of the events and violations of human rights, pointing out that the return to the 7th item leads towards the control of the United Nations and the formation of an interim national rescue government in country until elections. Tamimi said in a statement to the information that Iraq is taken out of Chapter 7 of the Charter of the United Nations under Security Council Resolution 32-90 in 2017 and the resolution has changed RAC from Chapter 7 to VI of this charter. E. added that Chapter 6, which turned to RAC, emphasizes peaceful solutions, especially since there are debts owed by RAC to weight up to $4.5 billion. He pointed out that taking RAC out of the previous chapter made it take control despite the survival of the United Nations mission in RAC to monitor and record observations, and what is happening today human rights violations at the moment is documented by the United Nations. He pointed out that the Security Council may issue a resolution on the return of RAC or Article 7, especially since the United Nations reports when there is a threat to civil peace, and when countries are unable to carry their internal problems. The United Nations provides advice and guidance and if it does not succeed, the Security Council decides to place the country under Chapter 7 and entrusts the administration of RAC to the United Nations to choose an interim national salvation government until new elections are held. Next article of interest. U.S. calls for lifting of restrictions on Iraqi press. November 4, 2019 inches Iraqi Communications News. Press statement by U.S. Secretary of State Michael R. Pompeo pictured. On the situation in Iraq, the United States welcomes any serious efforts made by the government of Iraq to address the ongoing problems in Iraqi society. The government of Iraq should listen to the legitimate demands made by the Iraqi people who have taken to the streets to have their voices heard. The United States is closely monitoring the situation and from the beginning we have called on all sides to reject violence. The government of Iraq investigation into the violence in early October lacks sufficient credibility and the Iraqi people deserve genuine accountability and justice. As the efforts announced by President Saleh begin, the recently imposed severe restrictions on freedom of the press and of expression must be relaxed. Press freedom is inherent to democratic reform. The U.S. government continues to support Iraqi institutions, the Iraqi people, and Iraq's security, stability, and sovereignty. Next article of interest. Iraqi president in Erbil to talk Iraq constitution edits, protests with Kurdistan region leaders. November 5, 2019 Erbil, Kurdistan region Iraqi president Barham Saleh landed in Erbil on Tuesday to meet the president of the Kurdistan region and Kurdish party leaders and discuss prospective amendments to Iraq constitution amid ongoing demonstrations across many of the country's central and southern cities. We will discuss efforts aimed at the amendment of the Iraqi constitution so we can have a unanimous voice as the Kurdistan region, Mustafa Saeed Kadir, vice president of the Kurdistan region, told Rudow English on Monday. Unanimity at this stage among Kurdistani political parties is important. Whenever a new development emerges, Kurdistani parties have in the past met. It is a normal thing to do now, to study the possibilities Iraq now faces, Kadir added. What matters is that the Kurdish parties will have to have a common stance. President Saleh, a Kurd, will take part in the meeting, Senior media officer of the president Hanna Qasim confirmed to Reuters, a wave of unrest broke over southern Iraq at the start of October as Iraqis took to the streets to demand government reforms tackling high unemployment, poor provision of services, and rampant corruption. Under mounting pressure, Iraqi parliament took drastic steps on October 28 to try to abate anti-government protests, voting to dissolve provincial and local councils, cut privileges of top government officials, and form a committee tasked with amending the constitution within 4 months. Van Sabri, a Kurdistan Democratic Party KDP member of the Iraqi parliament, told Reuters that the constitution amendment committee will convene later this week, but it remains unclear what articles will be put forth in the meeting for amendment. There are a lot of talks of changing the system from parliamentary to presidential, or the reduction of the number of MPs by increasing the number of voters they represent from 100,000 to 250,000 voters, she added. Kurdistan Region President Nurchirvan Barzani commented on the amendment of the Iraqi constitution while attending the 6th Congress of the Kurdistan Bar Association on October 31. The 2005 constitution designed for the new Iraq has been branded as advanced compared to the constitution of the majority of the countries in the region. However, not implementing its articles has created an atmosphere that means they are now talking about amending it. The main problem is not the constitution, but that this constitution has been ignored. It must be clear to all that any amendments being made must reflect the reality of the differences and the uniqueness of the country's components, and that the rights of all sides must be stipulated in it, Barzani went on to say. We will not impede any amendment aimed at improving the life and management of Iraq, but any amendment which will create inequality or harm democracy and federalism will be impeded, he warned. Parliament moved to open up the constitution to amendments has worried Kurdish parties. There are threats on Kirkuk in Kurdistan, and the main threat will be the denial of Kurdistani identity of disputed areas, Naimled Karim, former Kirkuk governor, said. Musana Amin, another Kurdish MP in Baghdad, believes Kurds must do their best to oppose the amendments, as opening up the subject will contribute to growing instability and further complicate existing issues that cannot easily be tackled. The rights of Kurds in the Kurdistan region guaranteed and specified in the constitution are all under threat, as per these people's desire. Hoshayar Zabari, a Politburo member of the Kurdistan Democratic Party KDP, told Rudawhiwa Jamal last week, Kurds were influential in writing Iraq post-Saddam Hussein constitution and secured significant rights in that document. Therefore, the constitution cannot be amended without the consent of Kurds, and the Iraqi parties very well understand that, Shakawan Abdullah, a former Kurdish MP in the Iraqi parliament, said. Our only guarantee in the democratic, federal Iraq is this constitution. If we open this, we will harm ourselves, said Hoshayar Zabari, a member of the KDP leadership and Iraq's former foreign and finance minister. Next article of interest. Iraq, arrests for voicing protest solidarity and Bar province detains, harasses people for Facebook posts. Counterterrorism officers arrested Samir Rashid Mahmoud from his home on October 26 for posting on Facebook that students and government employees in other governorates should strike to support fellow Iraqis participating in protests elsewhere in the country. Beirut authorities in Iraq and Bar governorate are suppressing the right of residents to show support for demonstrations elsewhere in the country, Human Rights Watch said today. In recent days, they have arrested two men for merely posting messages of solidarity on Facebook, questioned a third, and sent a fourth into hiding. Since October 25, 2019, the authorities throughout Iraq have detained hundreds of protesters at or after demonstrations, but the Anbar arrests stand out in that authorities arrested the men merely for showing their support over social media. Despite years of terrible conflict, many Iraqis have felt free to speak out on political issues, said Aralia Whitson, Middle East Director at Human Rights Watch. But these cases mark a disturbing change. If you contrast these men entirely peaceful political statements with a completely inappropriate response by the Anbar authorities. Protests started in Baghdad and southern cities on October 1, demanding improved services and more action to curb corruption. Security forces used excessive lethal force against protesters during the first wave of demonstrations from October 1 to 9. And again starting on October 25, 8 Anbar residents told Human Rights Watch that Anbaris did not intend to hold protests there, concerned that authorities would not allow them given the recent history of ISIS taking control over much of the governorate. A Facebook post from the Anbar Police Command on October 24 reinforced their concern. It said that Anbar Governorate calls upon its citizens to head to work and continue with construction, preserving security, supporting security forces, and benefiting from past lessons, from which the province has only gotten destruction, killings, and displacement. One man told Human Rights Watch he had so badly wanted to engage in the social movement that he had relocated to Baghdad, but he and others who spoke with Human Rights Watch said they read this post by the Anbar police as an implicit threat that authorities in Anbar would not tolerate any protests. Human Rights Watch interviewed the families of two men whom security forces detained after they posted messages of solidarity with the protest movement. At around midnight on October 26, Samir Rashid Mahmood, a 27-year-old man, posted on Facebook that students and government employees in other governorates should strike to support fellow Iraqis participating in protests elsewhere in the country. About an hour and a half later, his cousin said, counterterrorism officers arrived at Mahmood's home and detained him. They told his family they were arresting him for his Facebook post, which they said was inciting people to protest. The next day his cousin went to the local Interior Ministry counterterrorism office, where forces told him there had been an arrest warrant issued for Mahmood, but that they planned to release him soon without charge and that the family did not need to hire a lawyer. On October 29, when he had not been released, the cousin returned to the office and saw Mahmood in a cell over the facility CCTV, but officers refused to allow the cousin to speak to him. His family has yet to be able to speak to Mahmood. A second case involves a 25-year-old man who, a relative said, added a frame around his Facebook profile on the evening of October 26 to show solidarity with the protests. 4 hours later, five police cars arrived at his house and officers detained him. They hit him and accused him of inciting protests, before handcuffing him and putting him in one of their cars, the relative said. Authorities held the man incommunicado until October 31, then released him without charge. A third man said that after he posted on Facebook support for a strike in solidarity with the protests, several security officers questioned his colleagues about him and then questioned him, but let him go. Another man said that on October 25, he had posted several times on Facebook in support of the protest movement. On October 26, a friend who is a policeman called and said the police had issued an arrest warrant in his name because of his posts. He fled his home and is in hiding. The authorities should respect all Iraqis' right to freedom of expression and bring an end to harassment and intimidation of Iraqis peacefully supporting the protests. Human Rights Watch said, these arrests could signify a serious retrogression in free speech in some parts of the country. Whitson said, it's crucial for these cases to remain the exception. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that like subscribe button and check out the CEP Currency Exchange Planner. The link is in the description panel. Make sure to tell them the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-negotiated discount as my subscriber. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.